the vibrato system on the Improv5 and the Gig5, and also, of course, the system as we use it on our top model, the LW. Our vibrato system, again, is completely different than anything else you find on other vibraphones. Of course, we use the fans because that's a proven way of creating the vibrato you want from your instruments. But the difference between our instrument and any other vibraphone you'll find on the market is how we derive those fans. On any other vibraphone, you'll find an electric motor which does nothing but rotate. So the fans are always rotating. What you can do with that is you can adjust the speed on most of the vibraphones, and on some vibraphones you can even make the fan stop in the center position, but that's it. What we found is that many, especially jazz vibe players, don't want to use the vibrato system because they find the vibrato effect too much. It's too full, too deep. And we tried to come up with a system where you can control that. Now, we did that already on our LW instruments 10 years ago, but at that point on those instruments, it was still in, it was not so sophisticated yet. It was not, you could adjust the depth, but when you adjust depth, you couldn't adjust speed. Now, and nowadays, we use a completely different type of motor, where our motor does not rotate. Our motor is actually grabbing the fan shaft, the axles, and it moves them back and forth. So what we do is, instead of rotating the fans, we make them swivel. And by adjusting the depth, the angles of the swivel, we can adjust the depth of the vibrato. If you want nice deep vibrato, you make them swivel all from open to close, to open to close. But if you want just a small tiny vibrato, you make it just swivel a small bit, and you'll find even this small bit is already making a nice natural vibrato, but you'll never get with any other system. You won't get it even, I mean, what you want is you want to control depth on the spot. You don't want to have to change the size of the fans. You don't want to have to change the size of everything else just to change the depth of your vibrato. You want on some pieces of music, you want full vibrato. On other pieces, you want just a tiny bit. So, yeah. Now, because of the motor system we use, it's really very tiny. And what we've done is we've placed the motor inside the small end block. It's really nice, small. It's nicely embedded in the end block. It doesn't get damaged during transport. You don't see it. You don't have loose belts, which always get lost when you do a concert, or get damaged when you transport the vibraphone. Also, so on the small end block, we have embedded the motor. On the big end block, nicely convenient on top of it, we have placed the controls for the motor. And everything is nicely embedded. All the cabling is embedded from the outside. You don't even know the motor is there. Another good feature, nice feature about the system is that we've made it so it runs on any AC voltage from 100 to 240 volts. You don't have to mess around with external adapters, or you don't have to mess around with adding a big, huge power transformer if you want to go from a 220 volts area to a 110 volts area. You just plug in and it works. Now, the system, as I said, is different from any other system. And it already starts when you start up the Vibe. What will happen is at the first moment, it first has to find its reference point, so it knows where are my fans located at the moment. So when you switch on the Vibe, fans move to their reference point, and then after a few seconds, they move back again. Here they go. Now the vibraphone, the vibrato system, is ready for use. There are no fuses. There is no, because there's no way the motor even can get damaged. If you block something, the motor itself is software controlled. It's filled with sensors. It's constantly checking its temperature. If it gets too hot, it shuts down. If there's too much, if the fans block to something and it doesn't meet the actual speed it wants, it just adds a little bit more speed to the motor, and so you have a constant flow of the fans. You don't have to worry about the shape of the vibrato. People think that, okay, the fans, in normal situation, the fans rotate, so you have a fluid vibrato. Now, what we've done is we've programmed the motor such that, because we go from left to right to left, what we've done is, as soon as it reaches the outer limit, it slows down a bit, and then slowly turns around, and then speeds up, and slows down, speed up. Down, speed up, so have a really natural vibrato. So you don't notice that in sound, in effect, that you don't have a rotating fan, but you have a swiveling fan. Now, as said, the motor, when you start up, after it found its reference point, it moves to the open position, and the only thing you need to do is to make the vibrato start, is to press the button, and there it goes. Now, this button, on many vibraphones you find cheap switch. We don't do this. We use a high quality push button. There's also a lot of software on this side, there's a lot of software on that side, all to communicate and to make the best vibrato effect. You see there are two knobs here. The first knob is speed. And the second knob, that's the weird one, the second knob is for depth of vibrato. As you can see, it's only a tiny bit of vibrato, and the more I turn it open, the bigger vibrato is getting. Now, how does that sound? So here we have, it's a bit hard to focus because I'm not using the sharps. Here we have the effect without vibrato.